Now on Coast TV News.
Bringing new businesses to Millsboro, how the town is trying to offer more to the community.
From above, another potential new development in Lewis could be built here, why locals are angry over this growth.
Checking tire pressure, how to prevent low pressure during cold temperatures.
And speaking of that, there's been a shift in the showers that's going to arrive. I'm going to talk to you about that new timing coming up in a moment.
This is Coast TV News at 5.
A growing community looking for continued booming business. Good evening. I'm Madeline Overturf.
And I'm Charlie Sakaitis. Welcome to our News at 5. We begin tonight with Millsboro working to attract more business to town.
There are some business staples downtown, but town officials say they want to offer more to the growing population. Now live in Millsboro, we're joined by Coast TV News' Britt Leone. And Britt, you are outside one of the new attractions in town.
Maddie, Nectar is a popular Lewis breakfast and lunch spot. You've been there, I've been there, we both love it. And now it's coming right behind me here on Main Street in Millsboro. The town says it's going to open within the next month. People I spoke with in town earlier today tell me that they hope that restaurants aren't the only type of business that's up and coming here in Millsboro.
Charlene Truitt has helped manage her family's business, Truitt's Carpet Services, in downtown Millsboro for 38 years now.
Millsboro has always been good to us, and we in turn want to be good to Millsboro.
Charlene would like to welcome more business to town.
I think we need more businesses. I would love to see a sit-down restaurant other than fast food. A clothing store. We definitely need a clothing store of some type.
It's something the town is working on, with popular Lewis restaurant Nectar's second location coming to Main Street.
With more growth comes the need for infrastructure to support that growth, which is why the town is building a larger police department as well as this water plant behind me, which will double the town's capacity for water, only to help increase residential and business growth in town.
Town manager Jamie Burke says infrastructure like this is critical to attracting more business.
You need all those pieces in place for any kind of growth, which then attracts the retail.
Having those pieces in place is important for people like Charlene, who say the more the merrier.
We know everybody. We help one another, you know, that kind of thing.
Driving more business to a growing town.
Burke tells me the Chamber of Commerce has added some 20 new members that are all working on bringing more retail and restaurants here to the town of Millsboro. In Millsboro, I'm Britt Leone, Coast TV News.
Thank you, Britt. Well, one project that will help attract growth is coming with the help of Dell Tech. According to the town manager, Dell Tech is making a major investment in downtown Millsboro with the Williams House Conference Center at the corner of Washington and State Street.
After a day of confusion and discussion, Jim Jordan says he's not giving up the race for House Speaker. NBC's Alice Barr shows us how the Ohio congressman failed to win the speakership in two votes, leaving the House without a speaker for more than 2 weeks and Congress at a standstill.
A shift in strategy to kick the House of Representatives back into action after more than 2 weeks without a speaker, hitting another wall today. The current nominee, Judiciary Committee Chairman Jim Jordan, choosing not to push for a third House vote for now.
I'm still running for speaker, and I plan to go to the floor and get the votes and win this race, but I want to go talk with a few of my colleagues.
Chairman Jordan appeared to back a plan to temporarily empower the interim speaker, Patrick McHenry, enabling the House to pass critical legislation while Republicans worked to get on the same page. But after a lengthy closed-door huddle with GOP members, Jordan said there was too much opposition.
We made the pitch to members on the resolution as a way to lower the temperature and get back to work. We decided that wasn't where we're going to go.
Moderates in both parties had expressed support.
So that we can start moving our appropriations bills, aid to Israel, deal with the crisis in Ukraine, and our border.
This is imperative. It's a national security issue, international security issue now at this point.
A deeply divided House striving for a solution to get back to the work of the American people. In Washington, Alice Barr, NBC News.
And we have breaking news on this story. According to NBC News, Jordan says there will, in fact, be a third vote for Speaker today. Jordan said that this afternoon that he plans to call for a third vote on the floor today to see if he can finally reach that 217 vote number needed to be elected Speaker. As he passed reporters asking whether members would go for the floor for a third vote today, Jordan said, quote, "That's the plan," end quote.
Israeli troops were stationed near Gaza's border today after Egypt agreed to reopen its border crossing. The region remained volatile in the aftermath of an explosion at Gaza's hospital late on Tuesday, which Palestinian officials said killed 471 people. Israel and the U.S. said the cause was a failed rocket launch by Islamist militants in Gaza who denied responsibility. Tonight, President Biden is to deliver an Oval Office address at 8 p.m. to address the administration's response to the Hamas terrorist attacks against Israel. And also, he'll talk about Russia's war in Ukraine.
And this brings us to our Coast TV poll. We want to know, what should the U.S. do regarding the Gaza conflict? Let's take a look at the results.
Take a look at your screen. So far, 56%, a large majority, say nothing. They don't believe the U.S. should do anything, though 23% say political guidance, 3% say send troops, 18% say aid, which we have been seeing decisions being made like that.
Now, if you want to vote, it's very easy. You can go to CoastTVNews.com or use our Coast TV mobile app, and we will check back in later this evening.
Well, new today, Sidney Powell, a former attorney for former President Donald Trump, pleads guilty to Georgia election interference charges. Powell was one of Trump's lawyers after his 2020 election loss to Joe Biden. She pleaded guilty today to 6 misdemeanor counts in Fulton County Superior Court as a deal reached with prosecutors. Powell agreed to serve 6 years of probation, pay a $6,000 fine, and $2,700 in restitution to the state of Georgia. She also agreed to submit an apology letter to the citizens of Georgia and testify at related court proceedings.
The proposed Henlopen Bluff development started a heated, hours-long debate amongst neighbors in recent planning and zoning meetings that were held Wednesday night. The 79-lot community has raised concerns over the amount of traffic it would contribute to the Gills Neck Road area. And while in Wednesday night's meeting, the developer said DelDOT's assessment of the traffic impact from the neighborhood would be, quote, minor, not everybody is convinced.
I think that we are building at a pace that is outstripping our infrastructure. So it's too many houses, too much traffic on the roads without adequate thought as to how to manage all those additional cars.
The Lewis Planning and Zoning Commission will now need to make a recommendation to mayor and city council for this development.
Keeping your pet healthy and happy, on Monday, October 30th, the Humane Animal Partners will hold a free wellness clinic at BB Primary Care in Millsboro. Free pet vaccines will be administered. The clinic will run from 3 to 6, and appointments are first come, first serve.
Even though it's only October, Christmas is going to be here before we know it. The town of Selbyville has announced that it has an official toy drop site for the U.S. Marine Corps Toys for Tots program. Now through Friday, December 15th, those who wish to donate a toy may stop by the Selbyville Town Hall to place a new unwrapped toy, that's important, unwrapped, in the toy box. Town Hall is open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 4:30 p.m.
As we take a live look right now into the Lewis Yacht Club from our Tunnel and Razor camera, an absolutely beautiful view out there on the Delaware Bay. Let's check in with our First Alert meteorologist, Paul Williams. I was thinking about Alex. I don't know why, Paul, but good evening, Paul.
Good evening.
Maybe we were just talking about him.
Well, you know what? That's because Alex is a great guy. That's exactly right. You know, and so as we begin to take a look at our forecast, listen, we're looking at the Boardwalk Plaza point of view, and we see it's a very clear skyline for us and temperature of 65 degrees with the winds at about 12 miles per hour. But take a look at our detailed forecast. We're expecting 64 degrees by 6 o'clock, then we'll drop to 61 by 7 o'clock with partly cloudy skies. Now, there's been a change in the forecast since we last talked, because look at this increasing cloud cover going into the 9 o'clock hour. This is a precursor to how the rain that we've been talking about arriving on Saturday looks like it's going to try to sneak in a little bit earlier than expected, even for late tonight. This morning, we had a low of 39 degrees in Georgetown and in Salisbury, as well as Ocean City. So we've had more than just cool conditions. We've already dropped into the 30s.
And yes, that rain is on the way. We'll talk about the timing of that in a moment. Till then, back to you, Maddie.
Thank you. The seasons are changing and temperatures are dropping. And with that drop in temperature, people have begun to notice a drop in their tire pressure, too. Luckily, there are some things you can do to keep that tire pressure light from appearing on your dashboard.
Cold, the tire light's going to be on. When you start driving to work, you know, the sun's coming out, you're going, you know, molecules are expanding, your tire. So again, maybe set them a little bit higher, a couple pounds higher, 2-3 pounds higher in the wintertime to avoid that.
If you're unsure about the root of your low tire pressure, definitely visit your local mechanic for an inspection.
DelDOT has announced the closure of Jollins Roadway between Route 24 and Camp Arrowhead Road in Lewis. According to DelDOT, it's going to be closed due to paving work. DelDOT says work will take place starting Wednesday, November 1st through Wednesday, November 8th. Does your child have a knack for art? Well, DelDOT has announced a drawing contest. DelDOT is welcoming students in kindergarten through 12th grade to draw a picture showing what transportation in the future could look like. I think this is something I would have done in high school. DelDOT says submitted drawings could be featured on a cover of a book. Submissions are due by Friday, November 17th on DelDOT's website.
Sunfest kicked off today in Ocean City for its 48th year. The annual festival includes music, crafts, activities, and food from all across Delmarva and beyond. Artisans from across the country come to OC to show off their work. Sunfest is considered a great event for local businesses, even the ones that are not close to the inlet.
Well, I would say this is always a weekend I don't take vacation on because I know it's going to be a busy weekend when we typically have less employees available. So we kind of do have an all hands on deck for our employees.
Sunfest will be going on all weekend until Sunday at 3 p.m.
Still to come, the snooze button. We've all hit it, but how is it for you? Good news is it turns out that there's some benefits you might not know about.
First of all, snooze button with my favorite friend. Okay. Secondly, the landscape is changing on when the rain is going to arrive in our area. We'll talk about why it's getting an early jump on us, and I'll let you know what I'm tracking.
Homes across the U.S., the amounts of sales that have dropped in the month of September. We'll be right back.
Fall in love with Lewis.
Visit our unique shops and restaurants.
The Brush Factory is the area's premier destination for the unique and unusual for home, garden, and you. Come support our 60-plus local merchants and artists.
Indulge in the flavors of the season, fresh seafood, local produce, and aged prime Angus beef. Harvestide Restaurant, over the bridge in Lewis.
Cape May Lewis Ferry is sailing daily year-round and is ready to welcome you aboard. Gift cards and departure schedules available online at cmlf.com.
Lots to do and see.
In Lewis.
For 1 month only, all IG Burton Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram locations are offering vehicles at employee pricing. Ram, Grand Cherokee, Wrangler, and Gladiator, all offered at employee pricing. Up to $14,000 off all new inventory in stock. Plus finance rates as low as 2.9%, and you still get the employee price. Visit IG Burton Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram today in Melford, Smyrna, Newark, or Berlin to take advantage of employee pricing now through month end. Nobody beats a Burton deal. Nobody.
Transform your outdoor space with Backyard Works. We are Sussex County's one call for all your fence, deck, handrail, pergolas, shower, and trash enclosure needs. Locally owned and operated, we make all our vinyl and aluminum fence right here in Harbison, Delaware, from American-made manufacturers. Cut out the middleman and deal direct. As a TimberTech Platinum deck dealer, our trained team will professionally install your deck that will last a lifetime. Give us a call and let us make your backyard work.
Are you ready for a floor upgrade right now? Floor Coverings International can be at your home for a free estimate today. Browse carpet, tile, wood, and the area's best selection of LVP waterproof flooring, all from the comfort of your own home. You'll love our factory direct prices and white glove installation service. The best flooring store on the shore is the flooring store at your door. Call the number on your screen now to book your free in-home appointment with Floor Coverings International today.
This is Coast TV News at 5.
Home sales dropped last month to the lowest level in 13 years. Sales of existing homes fell 2% from August to September to a seasonally adjusted annual rate of 3.96 million units. That's according to a monthly report from the National Association of Realtors. This comes as surging prices and mortgage rates have pushed many would-be buyers out of the market. Another factor also putting a damper on home sales, a historically low supply of homes for sale. Low inventory is the one main reason, or one of the main reasons, why prices are staying high.
If you're a T-Mobile customer, take a close look at your next phone bill. The major wireless carrier is running a test in which it automatically switches some customers to more expensive rate plans. The change affects customers on older unlimited plans such as T-Mobile One, Simple Choice, and Magenta 55 Plus. All of those customers will be migrated to T-Mobile's 5G network plan, which starts at $75 per month per phone line. T-Mobile users will have the option to keep their current plan or opt out of the new one by calling customer service.
In health news, don't feel bad about your morning snoozing habits. A new study says snoozing your alarm can actually be beneficial. How about that? A new report published in the Journal of Sleep Research found that briefly snoozing can be healthier compared to waking up after the first alarm going off. The research found that the brief snooze periods can help against mood decline and improve cognitive functioning.
I wasn't about to feel bad about snoozing. Listen, we're in the clear for now, but early as late tonight, we could see a change in the road conditions that's going to change how you drive to work tomorrow morning because the rain's picking up momentum. I'll talk about the timing of it coming up on a moment. And don't hit your snooze button on this one, by the way.
Fall in love with Lewis.
Visit our unique shops and restaurants.
Be wowed by Puzzles and Lewis Gourmet, 30 years serving Lewis. Inspire your brain with jigsaws and more. Eat extraordinary with local and global specialty foods.
Autumn is in bloom here at Floral Inspirations. Come in for a cornucopia of flowers, plants, or gifts from around the world.
Or just come in for the smell of it.
Visit Conversation Piece Jewelers to choose or create the perfect jewelry gift for that special someone this holiday season. Shop local.
Lots to do and see.
In Lewis.
There's a joy that comes with building your new home on your lot, walking through your design, noticing the little things you visualized come to life, the progress, the completion, and the move-in to your new home. At Berica, we specialize in building strong, energy-efficient homes, custom-built in our factory and finished on your lot, wherever that may be. Tour our model homes and factory at our main office in Greenwood. We're happy to help you begin your journey in building your new Berica. Start online today at BericaHomes.com.
Fall in love with Lewis.
Visit our unique shops and restaurants.
R&L Liquors, your beach destination. Bourbon, spirits, fine wine, seasonal brews, and award-winning On the Rocks bottled ready-to-drink cocktails are here.
Blooming Boutique with women's clothing for all sizes and shapes. Your destination for resort wear, available year-round and the perfect gift for any occasion.
On-site coffee roasting and baking, Notting Hill Coffee Roastery Lewis Bake Shop offers espresso, sandwiches, smoothies, pastry, and an abundance of fresh coffee.
Lots to do and see.
In Lewis.
The Dots, classic hits from the 60s, 70s, and 80s. The Duck on 107.1, 105.1, and 104.3. The station where you know the words to every song. The Today Show, weekdays at 7 on Coast TV.
When choosing windows and doors for your home, at Pella, it's your choice. We manufacture maintenance-free vinyl, fiberglass, and wood-clad windows and patio doors, all with lifetime warranties. High performance, energy efficient, and loaded with options to help make your house your home. Industry-first features and benefits make living easier and increase your home's value. Visit our experience center or call us today to schedule your free in-home consultation where we bring the showroom to you.
So we've been tracking the rain pretty steadily and diligently, and we were talking about Friday and Saturday. Now, how about late tonight and Friday? I mean, I'm giving you the spoiler alert up front on what's happening with the forecast. That rain's just picking up momentum and just moving fast. Now, here's a look, courtesy of our tunnel and Razor camera. We're at 67 degrees at this present time. Now, I don't expect it to happen before midnight, but it wasn't supposed to happen close to midnight either. You see, as you take a look at our temperatures, we're falling into the 60s until 8 o'clock, then we'll fall into the 50s by 9 o'clock with increasing cloud cover. You see how we go from clear to increasing clouds? That's our first hint. Live radar, we see scattered clouds in the area. And as we kind of pull back out a little bit more, this rain shower activity that's coming out of the Ohio Valley region, that's the problem. That's why the rain's going to come in early and possibly cause you some problems as early as tomorrow morning on the way to work. High pressure system is here, but you know it's moving this clockwise rotation, so it has a better opportunity to pull some rain over us. Simplest way of putting it. So for tonight, long sleeves, no, but a hat and an umbrella because you want to keep the rain off you, particularly if you work third shift. Now, I'm expecting it to happen, the rain to sneak in here after midnight. So we're not talking about 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, but like 1, 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, that's what we're talking about in plain terms. It feels like 60s and 70 degrees right now in Redden. Our fall foliage report, by the way, if you want to enjoy how picturesque the leaves are, we're still at that patchy stage, but we're not near a peak, but we're already starting to see a lot of the leaves turn right now. So we take a look at Friday early in the morning. Look at what's happening. Going into 9 o'clock, look at these embedded thunderstorms that are pushing across. Very impressive here, particularly over Georgetown. It's going to be really a strong storm here. And as far as the amount of rain is concerned, we're looking at about a quarter of an inch of rain in some places. Saturday, we have that surge coming out of the northwest. But Sunday, it begins to clear out for us. But Sunday becomes very gusty with the winds. Look at this. Saturday at 40-mile-per-hour winds. Sunday, near 40-mile-per-hour winds. And that goes even into Monday. Here's a look at your Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling extended forecast. We're going to keep that rain on Friday. Saturday morning, a little bit of rain, but you know what? We're going to salvage the rest of Saturday.
A new test has shown a raccoon in Westover has tested positive for rabies. According to the Somerset County Health Department, a raccoon was found near Perry Road and Route 13. That's where the raccoon was found and then sent to the Maryland State Lab on Monday for rabies testing after a fight with a dog. Once infected, the department says rabies is a virus that has a 100% death rate when left untreated. So the department says vaccinated pets that come in contact with rabid or suspected animals, they need to be given a booster rabies vaccination within 5 days of that bite.
New today, over 700 bags of heroin found in a Dover woman's car following a traffic stop. According to the Dover Police Department, the investigation began just before 8 p.m. on Wednesday, October 18th, when officers observed 29-year-old Tanika McLean operating a Honda that was reported stolen from Maryland. Police say that a traffic stop was conducted and McLean was taken into custody. In custody, officers found 750 bags of heroin in the search of the car. McLean was then committed on over $50,000 secured bail.
The holiday season will be here before we know it, and that means the return of Draper Media's Bless Our Children campaign. Through generous donations from businesses and individuals, we do our best to make sure every child has a present to open Christmas morning. We do that by supporting nonprofits that handpick families in need, and applications for that are due October 31st. We'll be right back.
From gentle ocean breezes to small country towns, Sussex County has it all. That's why you need a real estate company that is familiar with it all. Mann & Sons offers decades of experience throughout Sussex County. Whether it's helping you purchase your forever home or find the perfect vacation rental at the beach, trust our experience. Trust Mann & Sons.
For over 30 years, the difference is clear. Mann & Sons Real Estate.
This weather's brought to you by
Fall in love with Lewis.
Visit our unique shops and restaurants.
Biblion and the Vintage Underground, your analog respites in a digital world. Books, vinyl, vintage clothing, and more. Open daily.
Eclectic style, estate jewelry, furniture, art. A curated collection to inspire.
Beautiful Nassau Valley Vineyards, the perfect place for tours, tastings, and impeccable events. Award-winning Delaware wines for 29 years.
Lots to do and see.
In Lewis.
We've got you. It's a pledge to make sure you're always taken care of. A pledge that your Touchstone Energy Cooperative honors each and every day. When it comes to keeping things running smoothly or getting them back on track when they're not, we've got you. Always.
The Delaware Electric Cooperative family is proud to keep the lights on.
Right.
right now, let's just run away. All that talk, it's killing me.
I wanna say I wish that you never left. Oh, but instead I only wish you the best.
1025 WBOC.
It's truck season here at First State Chevrolet in Georgetown, located on Route 113, just 1 mile north of the DMV.
Get interest rates as low as 0%, no payment for 90 days on this 2023 Chevy Silverado.
Save up to $6,500 on this 22 Silverado dump body.
Plus, we have a huge selection of Chevy certified vehicles.
Stop in or find us on the web at firststatechevy.com.
We're First State Chevy in Georgetown, where we put you, the customer, first. Find new roads.
Sponsored by Ancient Art Stone, where countertops are always a work of art.
In your entertainment news, Taylor Swift has dropped two new tunes that her fans can now listen to. The pop star announced on her Instagram page two new versions of her 2019 song Cruel Summer have been released. One version is a live recording from the Eras Tour, and the other is a remix. Swift wrote to her millions of followers on Instagram saying, quote, "For old time's sake, I'm releasing the live audio from the tour so we can all shriek it in the comfort of our homes and cars."
We want to let our viewers know that for some households that watch Coast TV news with an antenna, you might lose the experience of over-the-air signal of broadcasts on Tuesday, October 24th. There are technical changes occurring that day that may require temporary outage. A simple rescan for available channels, that will get Coast TV News back on the television lineup. We're going to be right back.
The new upscale OC Chopsticks Asian Bistro is the place to go for fresh, hand-selected ingredients used to create the most delicious Asian delicacies. Come dine in, have a drink, and let our skilled chefs prepare your authentic Thai, Chinese, and Japanese dishes. At OC Chopsticks, we take what was good and make it better. Sushi rolls, noodle soups, General Tso's chicken, you see where we're going. Anything made fresh is better. Serving lunch and dinner daily, located at the Ocean City Outlets. OC Chopsticks Asian Bistro. We stay fresh.
I'm attorney Ben Schwartz. We speak to people every day about bad experiences with doctors, nurses, and hospitals. But not every bad experience is a medical malpractice case. The cases we prosecute are wrongful death cases, catastrophic, serious physical injury cases resulting from errors by medical professionals. If you've been hurt due to a medical error, tip the scales of justice in your favor. Call Schwartz & Schwartz today.
Transform your outdoor space with Backyard Works. We are Sussex County's one call for all your fence, deck, handrail, pergolas, shower, and trash enclosure needs. Locally owned and operated, we make all our vinyl and aluminum fence right here in Harbison, Delaware, from American-made manufacturers. Cut out the middleman and deal direct. As a TimberTech Platinum deck dealer, our trained team will professionally install your deck that will last a lifetime. Give us a call and let us make your backyard work.
We decided to do upgrades on our house that we had built ourselves. We were looking for a particular company that would be on the same page we were as far as craftsmanship and take pride in a job well done. Now we're having the bathroom done, and we went with Spicer Brothers. I've never seen anything as fast and as efficient.
Unbelievable how quick he is for a one-man show.
He has a passion for his craft, and he's so efficient. We're just so tickled to death to have him.
So before you sign, keep Bass by Spicer Brothers in mind.
Bloomy Boutique, your place for fall fashion and resort wear all year.
Fashion, jewelry, and accessories as cool as an ocean breeze. You'll love this place. We put a smile on your face. You'll love this place. It's Bloomy Boutique. Fashion, jewelry, accessories, and fun. Bloomy Boutique.
Blooming Boutique with four convenient locations, two in downtown Lewis, Milford, and Long Neck, and easy online shopping.
Since the rain has decided to pick up the pace and get here a little bit early, tell you what, we're going to call for that rain on Friday, and we're not going to even include it for Saturday because maybe most of it should be out of the way by the time the sun comes up, because it's really going to hit us hard and steady for Friday. Now, for the rest of the week and going to next week, it's going to be a bit breezy, but by next week, we'll climb back into the 70s, which is kind of nice.
Thank you, Paul, and thanks for joining us here for Coast TV News at 5.
For more news, more local weather, download our Coast TV News app.
Inside Edition is up next.
And we're going to see you later tonight for Coast TV News at 6. Have a great evening.